I'm Aaron from PhoneDog.com, and you can't stop the Beats. You know, Beats Audio is making its way across several different HTC devices, but now it's finally available on a device in the United States. Here it is, the HTC Resound, Verizon's newest 4G LTE device, and it's going to be available on November 14th. So you European users have had some Beats devices for some time now. You know, the Sensation XE was the first Beats device available in Europe, and then the Sensation XL is on its way. Well, it's US users, we have something to call our own now. The Verizon HTC Resound is coming on the 14th, and it's going to be available for $299.99. Now, when you walk into Best Buy Mobile to purchase this device, you're going to walk out working. They're going to help you set up your email, your web on this HTC Resound with Beats Audio. They'll help you get everything configured on the music front, so when you walk out that door, you're working at Best Buy Mobile. But you can see that the HTC Resound, it comes with, obviously, Beats Audio. It comes with a pair of iBeats as well, which I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, well, I guess you can't really correct me, but you can tell me in the YouTube comments. I think those are $99.99 retail value. Standard lithium ion battery, which is 1,620 milliamp hours. You've got a pre-installed micro SD card that's 16 gigabytes, wall charger, quick start guide, product safety, and warranty brochure as well. So let's go ahead and open this sucker up and take a look. So we're gonna open it up. There is the device. This is what you're greeted to when you open it for the first time. You've got your iBeats earbuds right here, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull the device out itself. So it comes out in this nice little cardboard thingy, and you've got your earbuds here. So I'll go ahead and pull those out so you can see what they look like. And it's a pretty good pair of, you know, again, $99 headphones, if I'm correct, on the price. Getting those in the box for $299, considering the other LTE devices are already $299, is not a bad deal by any means. So you get these iBeats earbuds, they're in-earbuds, or in-ear earbuds, and then you get an inline microphone as well with back, forward, and play, pause, and answer the call. So nice looking little pair of earbuds. You get a Beats by Dr. Dre pouch as well to hold them in. It looks like you get some additional goodies down in here. Ah, some more earbuds, or some more ear tips, rather, so you can customize these to how you want them to be. So you can see those go right down in there. Easy open, easy close. And then you get the SIM card as well. And I'm interested to see, let's take a look at this. It is not a micro SIM card, it's a regular SIM card that goes in this. So that was something we were kind of curious about as to whether it was going to follow the Droid Razor and the Illusion, or the Droid Razor and the Stratosphere, rather, and be micro SIM, or if it was going to be original. So let's take a look at these. Consumer information about radio frequency emissions, blah, product safety and warranty information, master your device, important consumer information, información importante al consumidor. You know, like half the YouTube comments are like, this guy should never speak Spanish. And the other half are like, I love it when Aaron speaks Spanish. So that other half, you are welcome. And so you've got your cornstarch bags here that are environmentally friendly with a typical HTC stuff here, typical USB cable, typical AC adapter module as well. Like you haven't seen it a million times, but we can still take a look at it. And you get that in the box. But the real winner are the Beats earbuds. Getting those in the box, $99 value. Yours, not for free, but yours with the purchase of the device. So here's the Resound. I'm going to pop it out by doing that on the back. So to give you a rundown of the specs, 1.5 gigahertz dual core Qualcomm processor. It has a 4.3 inch display, and it is, I'm going to cheat here and look at the paperwork here, 4.3 inch true, which this is very factual, true HD 720p display. That's a real winner. Sorry about the noise outside. Sounds like the ambulances are, or the cops are coming to get me maybe, who knows. 4.3 inch true HD 720p display, 8 megapixel camera on the back with 1080p HD video recording, and then you get a front-facing camera as well. Now this is running Android 2.3. Actually, I do this every time, but I'm going to pull this off, and I'm not going to turn the device off, but I just want to show you what it looks like, because they focused on this in the presentation a couple weeks ago in New York. So you can see this kind of red coating, but you can look inside and see what powers your device, as they said, as Jimmy Iovine said. And then you have your 1,620 milliamp hour battery here. 16 gigabyte micro SD card pre-installed, and the SIM card slot is underneath the battery, so we can put that right back on. And you can see again, 4G LTE device, so they're getting a little thinner. This one is much thicker, at least, you know, especially after I've been working with the Razor, the Droid Razor, for a couple days. It's noticeably thick, but still it's thinner than the Thunderbolt, the Droid Charge, some of these initial, or at least feels thinner. I'll have to take a look at the final specs, but feels thinner than the first rollout of LTE devices. So you can see on the back here, got a nice texturized battery door, kind of got an incredible 2 look to it here. And you've got your micro USB charging port over here on the left side, your volume rocker on the right, typical HTC, 3.5 millimeter headphone jack up top, power button, and then nothing on the bottom. So it's running Sense 3.5 over Android 2.3, which is Gingerbread. Now this thing's going to be upgraded to Ice Cream Sandwich, according to the press release, in early 2012. So you will get Android 4.0, and they made a point of that in the meeting as well, or in the event as well. So since 3.5, so you're going to see some changes. It's kind of funny, or not really funny, but the HTC Vivid launched, what, a week ago, and it was running since 3.0, and it's already been triumphed, if you will, by Sense 3.5, which is what's on the Resound. So you can see some differences down here, and you see little differences all throughout the device, but you'll see some small changes like all apps and personalized written underneath the little dock there. You'll see some changes in here as well. When you go to quick settings, you can see Wi-Fi is prioritized up here, and you can't really tell on the camera, but I'm going to bring it in and let it focus in so you can take a look at really how clear and beautiful this display is. Let me try and get it in. There you go. Great looking display. And you know, even though it's running a kind of familiar version of HTC Sense, something that's kind of similar to 3.0, if you will, there are still some, it's a noticeable display difference in comparison to previous HTC devices. So you still get your same personalization options, but you'll notice the menu's changed as well down here. You can still scroll over, but it kind of categorizes everything. So you can see add to home, display, or sound. So here I can get my widgets, my apps, my shortcuts, my folder, typical Android stuff when you press and hold on the screen. It's going to bring that up. Then I can scroll over here to display. I can change the scene, the skin, the wallpaper, the lock screen shortcuts, and I can change the sound by scrolling over one more. So no real differences to the personalization menu, but they've kind of differentiated it in how it categorizes everything down here at the bottom. In terms of apps you get out of the box, and I do have to focus on this too, because this is something I loved about the Sensation XE. I love the red accents down here. You got your red capacitive buttons, and you've got a red grill up here, nice earpiece, and nice chrome accents, and then red ring around the camera. So typical Verizon stuff pre-installed, backup assistant, Blockbuster. You've got Hot Pursuit, which that is not a typical Verizon thing, but Let's Golf 2, and let's scroll down. Get it? Let's Golf 2. Let's scroll down. Ha ha. Mobile, that's a bad joke. It's Friday. I'm sorry. Mobile Hotspot, My Verizon Mobile, NFL Mobile Scan. Wonder what that does. Boo-doo-boo-ch. VCast Music, VCast Videos, Video Surf, VZ Navigator, and then you can always access this by scrolling over to Verizon Wireless. But again, notice how this is down here at the different, or down here at the bottom is different between downloaded, frequent. So again, just a minor change to the way it looks and how everything's categorized. But there's all the Verizon stuff that comes pre-installed, and I have a feeling like previous Verizon pre-installed software, you're not going to be able to uninstall it. But we'll take a look here just to make sure. Applications, Manage, let's take a look in here and see what we can do. Backup assistant, for example, yeah, you can't uninstall that. So go down here and take a look at one more. See if we can find one more. Hot Pursuit, let's see if we can uninstall. Can't uninstall that. So you get some Verizon bloatware out of the box, and you cannot uninstall it. So that may be a problem for some. And so you can see some minor changes here as well to all messages, SMS, and I can categorize by SMS and MMS and then individual voicemail. So again, no real huge differences from Sense 3.0, but you'll just notice that they look a little different, and they're a little bit, if I notice more black in this version of the interface as opposed to Sense 3.0. So you can see minor changes to the keyboard. If you're a real HTC fan, you'll pick up right away. The keyboard looks a little bit different, and you can, let's say the Quick Brown Fox, Quick Brown DOS is happy. Just wanna do a quick one. Quick Brown Fox is happy. Portrait and landscape, right there. And again, running a 1.5 gigahertz Snapdragon processor, but I thought that took a little bit too long, but maybe that's just me. We'll do some more testing in the coming days to see if it's really a device issue or not. But this should have HTC Trace built in as well. And I'm gonna go down here to the keyboard and take a look. And it does, good. So you have two keyboards in one, you have HTC Trace. Let's change the color to, let's do it to blue. And then we'll come back in here and take a look at the keyboard. So we'll say, hey there. And let's say, you know, I'm just typing along, pecking along, and I'm kind of sick of doing that. I can go back and say, how are you doing? I'm not really good at it. Hey there, ho, are you don't? How are you doing? Try it like that. So, you know, pretty easy to use. You can use it in portrait and landscape. And what I like is that you can use the same keyboard and easily transition back and forth without having to switch from, let's say, this to swipe and continuing to change your input method. So it's pretty cool that you can do that. And of course, you can turn that off if it's not a feature you think you'll use, but still nice to have that feature nonetheless. So a good looking addition to Verizon's 4G LTE lineup. It'll be interesting to see how this compares to the Motorola Droid Razr. Will we have dogfights? You betcha we will. And I'll have reviews as well in the coming days. Keep it locked on phonedog.com for continuing coverage on the HTC Resound. And while you're at it, like us on Facebook, facebook.com/phonedog. I'm on there. Actually, I'm on there today. It's a busy day, but I'm trying to respond to at least a few questions at facebook.com/phonedog. Hit me up on Twitter as well, phonedog_Aaron. Let me know you like this, you like the Droid Razr, you're waiting for the Galaxy Nexus. It's a hot holiday season, a lot of phones coming. Let me know which one you're excited for. PhoneDog_Aaron and on Facebook at facebook.com/PhoneDogAB. Thanks so much for watching. More coverage to come on the HTC Resound on PhoneDog.com.